Hello everyone, Reza here. Welcome to my channel. As many of you know already, the new Unreal Engine Marketplace Fab just launched yesterday. In this video, we're going to take a first look at the platform and cover everything you need to know about its features and what it has to offer. Let's get started. Let's start with your Epic Launcher, because what you see here, your marketplace, your library, your twin motion, reality capture, and your MetaHuman will eventually get integrated into the new platform called Fab. If I go start exploring and bring the browser here, you log in with your account, and you'll be greeted with this page right here, which is of course subject to change. From here, to access what you just saw in the launcher, you go into this icon here and you can see you have access to Unreal Engine, Create in Fortnite, your MetaHuman, which will link you to the MetaHuman page, a reality scan, reality capture, so on and so forth. So pretty much what you see in the launcher, you will eventually have access to via the Fab main page. Then in the main page, you have three options. Discover, which allows you to have access to all the 2D assets, 3D assets, animations, Atlas, audio, brushes, decals, tutorials, so on and so forth. So more like a one-stop shop, the first page where you can pretty much link your account to Megascan. You can download an asset and do 90% of your work in this first page. The library holds your vault in the launcher. So anything that you've downloaded in the vault in your Epic Launcher, you should be able to see that here, and you should be able to download that and access that in your Unreal Engine. As you can see, you have the same scenario in your library, in your vault, same icons. And then if you're a publisher, you can go publish, you can click on get started and agree with terms, and go with user agreement. Make sure to read all of that. Don't be like Reza, and agree and go next. And then you have the opportunity to publish your package, or let's say you want to create a button, or you want to have the full environment back together and sort of go through your tax setup and payout setup and publish on Fab. So everything can be accessible. Once your publishing is finalized, you can actually see that you're published within the content that you see here. The cool thing about that is there are some key publishers available, including Kitbash 3D. So I can go in there, go explore now, and have a look at what they have to offer. Pretty much the same price I noticed, but one key, I would say, difference between this and the legacy platform is this license here that you need to be mindful of. And this pretty much is there for all the assets that you would like to buy, apart from the Quixel that is free at the moment and some feature free content. You can see featured sellers. If I go ahead and click on any of them and pick any of them in here, you can see the licensing is there, as well as some very useful information in here to talk about the compatibility, what you can see, so on and so forth. But if I select the license, you can see I have professional and personal, and it comes down to budgeting, what sort of studio you're running, for studios and other entities with over 100k revenues or funding in the past 12 months, you have to obtain professional and for personal creators, indie artists, game developers who are running a rather smaller studios, they can acquire the personal license. You can also pick from the categories in here. So the cool thing about that is you no longer see only Unreal Engine Marketplace. You can also see some Sketchfab assets in there too. Another thing is you can see a little bit of variety, UEFN, Unreal Engine, and Unity, and bring them into the mix. So if I go into, let's say, 3D models, and let's say I'm going to pick this antique sofa bench, you can see now I have this 3D viewer, which I have to say is not available for every single asset, but you now switching into sort of a Sketchfab style where you can actually see everything in 3D. You can go in there and have a look at the render, just the base color, just the roughness, normal, and you get a really nice wipe in here. Just a matte cap, check out the UVs, and only look at the wireframe if need be. In here, it shows you what sort of extensions you can download per asset, which is more or less coming from Sketchfab, many of these. And again, you have the same professional and personal license that you need to be mindful of. In case if you wish to look for similar items, you can go in there and say, I want to look into furniture some more, bench, sofa, or antique. So tags are associated with every single asset that you will see in here. So I can go in there and only look for antiques, and it brings some more antiques elements that you can have a look at, like for example this one right here, and browse around and see if that kind of works for you. So I would call this an improved version of the Unreal Engine Marketplace. Obviously, if I go into Sketchfab, it should be closed by now. So yeah, the Sketchfab store is closed and everything more or less has been transferred into Fab platform. Another cool thing you can do is to go to the main page, get all Quixel Mega Scan for free, claim now, claim free Mega Scan, click on that, and that's it. Mega Scans claimed. That gives you free access to all Quixel Megascan library, which is like over 17,000 assets, through the end of 2024 for all the engines and tools, including Unity, which is pretty cool. Also, another cool thing is this new free Substance 3D painter and modeler. There is a tiny gacha, so it's not like free for everyone. If I click on this and go explore now, you can see that it is free, but you have to either publish something, it doesn't matter the size, the complexity of your published asset, or make a purchase over 25 USD to get the redemption code. Obviously, each Epic ID user is eligible for one code, and Adobe allows only one code redemption per Adobe account. So redeeming multiple codes through Fab is not allowed. And there's a time frame for it. So all codes must be redeemed by May 21st, 2025. So that's another thing that is a bit of a disclaimer here. You kind of need to be mindful of that as well. The rest is fairly self-explanatory. You can see now my Mega Scan claim has been ticked, and I can use all the 17,000 assets from mega scans in here with no issues. I can go into different platforms. So platform Unity, you can see we have different channels, and that's another cool thing that you get channels to find content compatible with Unreal Engine, UFN, and Unity. We've got three channels at the moment. And you can see now I can, based on the channel I pick, I can go ahead and find compatible content. Apart from that, there is a bit of a roadmap going on that in 2025, Epic Games will offer a selection of Megascan libraries for free. So it's no longer free all for everybody, which kind of something that is going to change a few bits and pieces. Also, there will be upcoming improvements on this platform. That's why I call this the first look, because this will change eventually. So what Epic Games is saying that additional five formats like Roblox and Minecraft assets will be added to this list. Also, access to MetaHumans will be different. So right now we are going into actually MetaHuman webpage to be able to do everything. There is a talk that this will get integrated just like Twinmotion within this platform. So you no longer need to exit this page and go to another page to sort of do your MetaScan work if need be. There will be product specific frequently asked questions to make sure that if you're sort of confused about a particular part, that can be addressed and answered properly. And streamline pipeline for creators to publish content from Unreal Engine to Fortnite UEFN directly to FAP, which can be a really convenient thing for game developers. Also, there will be a tiny plugin under Windows under Quixel Bridge. So we should be able to see FAP in there very soon. And that will connect you to that, just like Marketplace or Quixel Bridge. You should be able to see FAP in there. It's not available yet. I would like to think it's coming very soon. And you should be able to directly connect to FAP through Unreal Engine without sort of exiting Unreal Engine. You should be able to access all of that. You can see there is a standard license for some of these, apart from personal and professional. So we have Creative Common and FAB's standard license, which allows asset use across any game engine or tool. Something to be mindful of. If I click on this, there is a user agreement that is very specific about the terms and conditions and how to use licensing or tiers. Now, let me summarize this for you, because going through this can be somewhat confusing. It's all about license tiers on FAP that is offered with different levels. We're talking personal and professional, and we did see that with some of these items. So if I go in 3D model and, I don't know, pick something, the first thing that I mentioned was this license, personal and professional, and I did talk about it. Basically, part of this is about that if your total revenue from digital content in the past 12 months is less than $100K US, you can select a personal tier. And if you select a tier that you're not eligible for, you will need to pay the difference upon request, obviously. Then we talk about standard license. With the valid transaction, you're granted a standard license, allowing you to use the content on any platform or tools. Then we have alternative license, which some content is offered under open source licenses. in which case you will receive an alternative license. The format you can access heavily depends on your selected license peers. So make sure to kind of go through the whole thing to understand what exactly is happening. But I can see some significant changes in there from Epic Games. So definitely check that out. Apart from that, there is really not much else to discuss. That should do the trick for us today. Thanks very much for watching, and see you in the next video.